We're cats. Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science here, your festive beauty and skincare science nerd. Christmas is coming and I'm getting a whole bunch of questions about what would make an appropriate skincare gift. I had all these grand plans to wear like really cute reindeer antlers, but I think I might have left them at work from like Christmas last year. So I've had these cat ears instead, but cats aren't really that festive. I know it sounds a bit like my dog ate my homework. I really tried. I have tinsel, I have this festive Santa thing, I have some alcohol. I'm wearing the tinsel, it's really itchy, and I feel like it's not really worth it because you can barely see it on screen anyway. This is the best I could do in this situation. I don't know if the reindeer antlers would fit in the frame anyway. Maybe if I sat like this. I have this reindeer antler ring instead, which makes me super Christmassy, right? If your friends and family know that you're a skincare nerd, you might be getting a lot of questions about what to gift people in terms of skincare. Or maybe you have someone in your life who is obsessed with skincare and you really want to give them something special. So I thought I'd do a video discussion about what sorts of products are safe and appropriate and give you some gift ideas so that your shopping will be a bit easier. If you like this video, I'd really appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Alright, first off, is skincare a good gift? This is really itchy. I'm gonna take it off. This is gonna become like strip Christmas. Strip skincare. Is skincare even a good gift? So this is a pretty controversial topic, and I asked a bunch of you guys on Instagram what you thought. I got a whole lot of mixed responses. Skincare isn't like an all-out bad idea like gifting a pet.
Did you hear that, Truffle? Not everyone wants a truffle as a Christmas gift. Oh, I'm sorry, Truffle. You look so uninterested. You love being on camera. You're always trying to be on camera. Why don't you want to be on camera when I actually want you to be on camera?
And I think whether or not it's a good gift depends on the exact type of skincare you're gifting and the person getting it, because skincare is a pretty personal sort of choice. So I thought I'd come up with some general guidelines to help you work out if you should even be gifting skincare to someone. All right, guideline number one. Don't give someone skincare for treating a problem like acne or aging unless they specifically ask for something in that category. I think this is a rule that should never be broken because it can come across like you're telling them that they look old or that they're really spotty and they need to fix it, and it's just really awkward. It's in the same category of faux pas or like female relative neg. It's like when you assume that someone's pregnant, or you give someone deodorant, or you suggest that maybe they should eat a bit less, or give them tips on how to bind their big ass feet so that they can find a husband. This is a true story. I have a Chinese grandmother. My feet are size 36 for all of you single men out there who are looking for a wife with small feet. My second guideline is, if they've ever said something about sensitive skin or allergies or rosacea, then skincare is probably somewhere where you should tread pretty lightly. If someone has sensitive skin, then they probably have this massive long checklist of what they look for and avoid in skincare. They probably avoid fragrance and some of the common preservatives as well. So that means if you want to give them a safe skincare present, then you're generally left with really boring skincare products like a tub of Vaseline or medicated cream, which is probably useful, but not really the sort of gift that really does much as a gift. It's kind of like gifting someone cling wrap or toilet paper. Practically speaking, it's really great because you'll definitely use it. But in terms of what you want to find under the Christmas tree, it's probably not high on the list. It's like two circles in a Venn diagram that just don't intersect. It's probably also not a great idea to give someone skincare if they have really strong opinions about skincare. If you buy them a trendy new product, then they either probably already have it, or they've already decided that they don't want it. In this situation, you should probably ask them if they actually want a particular product before you go out and buy it, or just ask them what they want. I personally don't like surprise gifts because I have pretty much never gotten anything I actually wanted, so I'm pretty jaded about the whole idea of surprises. But I know that a lot of people have had better experiences in this particular area, so the surprise factor is important for some people, and obviously this will just kill it.
Oh, so much fur. That's why no one wants you.
Okay, so if you've decided that gifting skincare is a good idea for this particular person, here are some safe skincare gift ideas that I've come up with. This video isn't sponsored, but I do feature some products that I've received as PR samples in the past. A safe skincare gift would be a gift card to their favorite store. This is obviously a safe option, but it feels a bit less personal, and it seems a bit lazy as well. But in terms of giving them something that they'll actually use and treasure and that won't just rot in a corner, then you can't really beat this. You can make it a bit more personal if you give them like a small, inexpensive item to go with the gift card, and there's some really cute options out there. So for example, Mecca, which is a store in Australia, they have this gift card, which comes with a little product as well. So this year it is a hydrating mist. So that makes it a little bit less, I've given you money. My next guideline for good skincare gifts is that body products are generally a lot safer than face products. Face skin is a bit thinner and it's a lot more sensitive, so it's more prone to breakouts if you've got the wrong products. And it's a lot more visible as well if you do happen to have a reaction. Most people are a lot less specific about what goes on their body rather than their face, especially when it comes to things like fragrance. So you can have a bit more fun with this with less of a risk, unless of course the person has really sensitive skin or they're sensitive to fragrance, in which case probably just don't go there. Body products are also a good idea because they tend to be larger volume products that get used up very quickly. So if you give them travel size products, then it's good for traveling as well because it tends to be in larger containers, and so carrying it around is a bit of a pain in terms of luggage. Most beauty people do prefer travel size products if they're not sure about a product. There's less waste if they don't like a product, and most things are better than hotel products, although I've been to a few really nice hotels which had like L'Occitane products. Anyway, body products are generally a lot safer. Some of the products that might make good gifts are body moisturizers, hand cream, shower gel, nail care, hand sanitizer. One of the brands that I really like for body skincare gifts is The Body Shop. I actually did a sponsored post with them recently showing off their Christmas range. I was actually going to include them in this video before they approached me to do a sponsored post. I really like them because they have a bunch of gifts which partially go towards charity. They're really nicely presented as well, so you don't have to put too much effort into wrapping them and making them look good. And they have sets with lots and lots of different price points, which makes it really convenient for things like Secret Santa gifts. So The Body Shop have a bunch of different gift sets. So for example, if you know that your person really likes strawberry, you can buy them a whole pack of different strawberry stuff. And most of these packs have lots of convenient travel sizes. If you don't know what scent your giftee likes, then you can also get like a variety set so that hopefully there's at least a few things in there that they'll enjoy. There's also Lush, which has really good one-use products like bath bombs and bath melts, which means that if your person doesn't really like the product, again, there's not that much waste. My favorites are the bath melts, they're really moisturizing. But before you get a Lush product for the bath, check that they actually have a bath and that they take baths. Otherwise, I guess they do smell really nice anyway, so you can put them in your sock drawer, but probably better to ask. Another good category of gift is the advent calendar. They usually have lots of travel size products and just a nice range for your giftee to try. Lots of stores have really nice advent calendars. You can also get one from their favorite brand. The Body Shop has some as well. If you're feeling quite creative, you can also make your own DIY calendar. You can buy a calendar box from somewhere like Amazon and then just put little travel size products into it to give your giftee something pretty unique. If you want to gift face products, then I think the best ones are the more generic products that don't stay on your face for too long. So things like cleansers, makeup remover, masks, and lip balm are pretty good for that. You can also try gifting a fancy skincare set. Ideally, it would be fragrance-free. If you want to go for something pretty luxe, then you can try a more clinical sort of skincare brand. For example, Synergy from Australia, they've come out with a few gift sets that are really nicely packaged in travel bags, and they contain products that are pretty suitable for a lot of different skin types. So this one has a cleanser, it's got niacinamide, which is pretty much good for everything, and a daily moisturizer which has sun protection in it. Another one of my favorite brands, Ultraceuticals, has also come out with a whole bunch of different skincare sets. They've come out with a hydrating set that pretty much all skin types can use. You can also try gifting skincare tools, so things like body sponges, face washing towels, face halo, microfiber cloths. And it's especially good if it's a category of tool that you should be changing every once in a while as well. And hopefully it can still be a little bit fun, so probably not like cotton pads, but maybe some reusable cotton pads would be good. Also maybe a silicone mask, like the ones you can get from Daiso, which was a suggestion I got from someone on Instagram, thank you for that one. In the sort of middle price range section, you might try giving a jade roller or a pair of tweezers, because tweezers are really useful and go missing a lot. If they're a massive skincare and data nerd, then maybe they might like a hydration tool like the Wayskin. If you want to go really high-end, then maybe a device like the Panasonic microcurrent tool or the New Face or the Zip. I probably wouldn't gift a cleansing brush because I feel like people tend to overuse them a lot, but maybe something that's silicone like the Foreo. Finally, I think gifts that aren't strictly skincare but sort of skincare adjacent are really good as well. You can try gifting them a spa voucher, so it's something that's quite indulgent that they probably wouldn't buy for themselves. There are a few versions available where you can let the person choose which spa to go to. Travel bags are really good as well. I feel like you can't really get enough travel bags, and they come in so many different price points as well. If you want to go more fancy, then you can give them like a monogrammed one. But even inexpensive transparent ones come in handy a lot for things like plane trips. Skincare storage is also something that a lot of skincare addicts really need. So things like a skincare shelf, which, like this one, which I'm currently using for everything but skincare. There's also a rotating shelf that I've been really fond of, which works really well if your skincare addict has limited storage space. Acrylic drawers are really nice as well. You can get some from Muji, which are really solid, really high quality, and sort of a splurge. If they're really nerdy, then maybe gifting them a skincare book might be good. I'm enjoying this one called Beyond Soap at the moment. I also have an ebook out which you can give as a gift. The Lab Muffin Guide to Basic Skincare.
Beauty science. Beauty science. Oh, you hate science.
There's tons of other skincare adjacent gifts as well. Things like skincare fridges, light up mirrors, humidifiers, silk pillowcases, and even something small like skincare stickers that you can put on your skincare to say when they've been opened. So that's a rundown of the skincare gift ideas I came up with. Hopefully that comes in handy if you're planning to give skincare to someone. I'm sure you guys have lots of ideas as well. If there's something I left out that you think would be a fantastic idea, then leave it in the comments below. Good luck with your gift shopping. Don't forget to take some time out for yourself. Don't rush around too much. If you like this video, I'd really appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram and check out my blog for more articles about the science behind beauty products.
Say goodbye, Truffle. Bye-bye.